Have you brushed your teeth and combed your hair? Are you in your pajamas ready for bed? Are the curtains drawn and blankets tucked tight? Are you ready to sleep and say goodnight? But before you go into your dream ride, here's a story for you tonight. Hello everyone! Tonight, as you can see, we have a story of two little elephants. And this story is dedicated to Shweta Mama and little Charvi. Congratulations, Shweta Mama. You are going to have a baby soon. So this story is for the two of you. So tonight we have the story, We Love Bunk Beds. Do you know what are bunk beds? Bunk beds are bed which is one bed over the other. That's right, that's a bunk bed. And it is so much fun to sleep on bunk beds, and especially if you are with your sister or your brother. It is lots of fun. Yes, it is. Some bunk beds come with a slide. Some bunk beds come with a step. It is so much fun. So here we go. We Love Bunk Beds by Paula Metcalf. No matter where Shirley was, this is Shirley, the older sister, and this is the little one. This is the baby. So, no matter where Shirley was, her little sister Doris was never far away. Doris wanted to be with Shirley everywhere. So Doris loved her older sister so much that she wanted to be with her everywhere. And look at that, Shirley is such a sweetheart. She is absolutely not upset. Yeah, she's not annoyed that her little sister is with her. Oh, that's so sweet. This was not always a good thing though. Oh, look at that. They're trying to play on the seesaw and Doris wants to be with Shirley. How can you go seesaw if both of you are on the same side? Doris, you are so funny. Oh no. But if Mummy ever needed to find Doris, she never had to look very far. Mama always knew that little Doris was somewhere around Shirley. Oh my God. Look at that. Poor Shirley is trying to change her clothes and Doris is right on her back. Oh, Doris, you being a little too clingy. Shirley got so used to her sister being around that she sometimes forgot that Doris was even there. Oh my God, she put her t-shirt on with Doris on her back. That is so funny. But look at that, Doris was all the time with Shirley, so Shirley almost forgot. Shirley loved to ride her bike and so did Doris. But Mummy worried that this was dangerous, so she bought the girls a present. I would also think this is dangerous. My God, Doris is clinging to Shirley everywhere. Now Shirley is being such a good big didi, big sister, and she is taking Doris everywhere with her. But riding a bike like that, that's something even I would worry. So I think Mama is right in worrying. Now what is the present Mama got? Mama got a double bicycle. But oh dear me. Sighed Mummy. Doris was still clinging to Shirley. Oh, Doris, you have to learn to ride your own bike. Let's see what happens. Shirley and Doris shared a bedroom. Doris' side of the room was always neat and tidy. But Shirley's wasn't. Poor Shirley, her bed wasn't big enough for two growing elephants. Now Doris' side of the bed is definitely going to be clean because little Doris never uses her bed. And poor Shirley, she has to be cramped up in a small bed with Doris clinging to her. Now what is Mama going to do? Let's find out. One day, Mummy said, "You're a big girl now, Doris. Wouldn't you like to sleep in your own bed?" Doris didn't like Mummy's idea very much. Now Mummy is trying to get Doris a new bed. But Doris did not like that. But then Mummy had another idea. "Everybody in the car," she called. "We're going into town." So Mummy is taking the girls to town. Let's see what they're going to do. In the furniture shop was something Doris had never seen before. Bunk beds! "If we got bunk beds, Doris," said Mummy, "you would stay close to Shirley every night." Luckily for everyone, Doris loved the idea. Mummy ordered the bunk beds. They would be delivered next Tuesday. My God, finally, Doris, I am so proud of you. You have learned that you should be sleeping on your own bed. And if they are on the bunk bed, Shirley and Doris, both of them would be very close by. Doris quickly became a bunk bed expert. "The best thing about bunk beds," she explained, "is that sometimes you can sleep on the top and sometimes you can sleep on the bottom." "Exactly," said Shirley. "We can even swap over every night if you like." What do you mean by swap over? Meaning exchange. Shirley can sleep on top one night and Doris at the bottom. And the next night, Doris can sleep on the top and Shirley on the bottom. "Hooray!" shouted Doris. "I can't wait!" Neither could poor Shirley. She wanted her space. Finally, the bunk beds arrived. "Top or bottom, Shirley?" asked Doris at bedtime. Shirley couldn't believe her luck. She crumpled up to the top bunk. Now, Doris gave Shirley a choice. "Do you want to sleep on the top or the bottom?" Now, Shirley was so happy. She's like, "Oh, finally." So she climbed up on the top bunk bed. "Good idea, Shirley," said Doris. And she climbed up on the bed too. "Tomorrow, we will sleep on the bottom." "Oh my God, Doris, I thought you learnt your lesson." Funny Doris. She loves her sister so much that she just doesn't want to let go. Oh dear me. So little Charvi, when you have your little baby sister or baby brother, you tell me how you're going to be. Are you going to share all your things with your little baby? Or you are going to make sure that your things are kept separate and the baby's things are kept separate? That's fine too. Tell me about it. I'll be waiting to hear from you. On that note, good night. Sleep tight. Don't get into any pillow fights.